Now we are in the concluding classes, lesson number one. Okay, if I ask you, what is lesson number one I have taught? Tell me, can you tell me? Tell me. Nanu. Nanembudu. Nanalla. Ideha. Manabuddhi. Nanalla. Sachidanandatma. Shivananani. Shivoham. 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 This is the first lesson and this is the last lesson. Understand? Entire spirituality of whatever Vedanta says is only captured in this one line. So this is the first lesson and last lesson also. No, we'll come to that. We'll come to that. They're actually supportive. This is the only lesson which you have to learn. Okay? Now it has to be learned in such a way that right now, whenever you interact with people, you have a deep-rooted feeling and concept that I am the body. Okay? By default, you are a body. Once in a while, you remember your Atma. Okay? Because your nervous system, body is all tuned to I am the body. Okay? It's programmed over 7 years. With this knowledge which I have given to you, you have to deprogram yourself. And nobody can, Guru cannot come and deprogram you. You have to stay at least some time every day as I am the Atma. So gradually this program, the I am the body, will go. And this practice is called Samadhi practice. By doing Samadhi practice repeatedly, you will attain Sahaja Samadhi, means natural Samadhi. It's almost saying, initially when you learn cycling, a lot of struggle. Okay, you'll fall off. Okay? Somebody has to hold you, right? After some time, cycling will become so easy, you will cycle without holding the handle also. So like that, Samadhi practice, again and again done, the nervous system will get retuned for I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am the Atma. And that is called Sahaja Samadhi. Okay? Right? So what you have to come after Sahaja Samadhi? I am the Atma Shivoham. So that Jnana should be clear in all the interactions in life. So once in a while you'll remember I am the body. Understand? Once in a while I'll remember I am the body. Otherwise I am the... No, without remembering anything. You are just Atma operating in the world. Not closing the eyes, not doing any breathing. Just you are the Atma operating in the world has to come up to that point of time. So up to that point of time, you need support and practice. Okay. Again and again. So that you are established in Sahaja Samadhi, means natural state. Is this much clear? This is lesson number one and lesson number five. Okay. So second lesson is, you have to realize, the second realization actually, I am not lesson. Realization, Shivoham means I am consciousness. I am pure consciousness. So as you are established in pure consciousness, you will realize gradually everything is consciousness only. I am Shivoham, I am consciousness. And Sarvam Kalida Brahma, all this is also consciousness will come. It will not everything appear as something vague, floating. Everything you say, you will be very clear, and not because knowledge, but because you are established in that, you say, all this is consciousness only. That means you are not limited to a body, you cannot say infinite also. The consciousness only is there. The consciousness and the matter will not be there. Right? So the duality will disappear. What is the duality? I and you. I am there, you are there. I and you. I am there, the world is there. I am there, God is there. I am there, Brahman is there. All those dualities will disappear. When the duality disappears, there is peace. Okay. In that peace, you are in natural state. You don't even say non-dual. You know, everything is consciousness. Just like now, you know, everything is matter. Okay. Everything is consciousness. Will become your living experience. That's called Jivan Mukti. Okay. No, I close my eyes, the matter disappears. No. With the eyes open, you should have realization that everything is conscious, that God, everything is God. When I means ego disappears, then what remains is God. That becomes a living experience. Aham Brahmasmi, I am Brahman, not as I as ego, the real consciousness. Then the world is consciousness. So the consciousness alone becomes the reality, and that is the final realization. So you should not stop in between somewhere. Then you'll be hanging around like Trishanku Sarga, neither here nor there. Okay, no, I have understood. But are you I am the Atma has become your natural state? Or you have to remember it. And the world is consciousness, is become natural state? Remember it. You have to remember it. So this is your test. Okay? So you have to, up to that point, your vasanas, impressions will be there. Jnana will be there. Jnana will be overriding. That's why you say, oh, sometimes I get angry, I will come back, because jnana is coming and triggering it. Now if your vasanas have to go, then you have to practice samadhi. Samadhi is a cleaning up process. Impressions are to be cleaned, okay. Accumulated. Not necessarily to be cleaned also. You say jnana is sufficient for me, it's fine. So, but then you say, no, I want to have a very clean vasanas. You have to do samadhi practice. Okay? Jnana itself is sufficient. Jnana itself is fulfilling. I'm not a body, that is fulfilling. But if you want to go a little bit and clean up, then the clean up has to happen through samadhi. Is this clear? Second thing, when everything is consciousness, what will happen? When the matter is there and consciousness is there, I am experiencing the banana. So the banana is there, I am there, there's the experience there. There are three. Okay? There's three. So when consciousness is there, then what will happen? Experiencing will be there. Okay? Experiencing will be there. Neither I nor banana. Experience will appear and disappear. Just like waves appear in ocean and disappear. But ocean doesn't create the wave. There's no dual. So you will reach a stage. There's experiencing, but there's no experiencer. There's thinking, but no thinker. There's doing, but no doer. There's enjoying, but there's no enjoyer. The subject has disappeared into Atma, the object has disappeared into consciousness. Then only experiencing is there, and experience is knowing. The knowing is Atma. Other than Atma, nothing will be there. That is actually stage of complete realization. If you stop in between somewhere, you are actually not reached the full destination. Even though destination is obviously there, it's already there in front of you, you're not reached it, because you will always have a question, have I reached or not? Okay, so is this clear?
Experiencer is the Atma.
No. Atma experience. Doesn't experience. Experiencer is the ego. Okay, so that will come to that. So Sarvam Kalidam is only God alone is there. That realization will happen. Okay, so that is the final. Till that time, if you are in between, you are not, you have to continue. Practice, okay? So now what is continuation? Is Shravana Manana Nididhyasa. Nididhyasa means Samadhi practice. Shravana means listening. Listening to what? Only Atmadnana. Oh, I'll go to this satsang, I'll listen to that satsang, nothing will add value to you. Only focused Atmadnana teaching by a realized master, realized masters will help you. Otherwise, you'll start going into another spin. Okay? So, what happens is that in Atmadnana process, there are a lot of confusion will come. Different type of one. These confusions have been addressed by masters like Ramana Maharshi, Sri Shankara, Atmananda Krishna Mena. They have been addressed. Study their teachings. Listen to the teachings. Actually, every day I keep doing something and broadcasting. Various questions which are coming up in the sadhaka's path are addressed. Okay? So, by your own way, this thing, you will not be able to address that, because the questions are addressed based on the many students, masters have addressed, all those things are being put in the talks. So, somewhere something will click in you. Okay? So, the adnana will start dissolving. That's why shravana, manana, nididhyasa. This has to be a continuous process. Nididhyasa means samadhi practice or meditation practice, which I am going to teach you. Is it clear? So, Atmadhyana, there are very, very focused texts which are related to Advaita. And even Advaita texts also will be very confusingly told to many people. Very clear exposition of Advaita, very, very clear way. So, ignorance will get removed is what you are. Just don't listen to some text because it gives you entertaining. It may feel happy about it. Your Adnana has to be piece by piece, has to be cut. Okay? Understand? So, don't listen to any scriptures because I want to accumulate knowledge. Right? Listen to scriptures because I want to drop knowledge. You understand? The subject, the Vedanta is called Veda Anta. Veda means knowledge. Anta means end of knowledge. Okay? Our burden in life is knowledge. That's why Shiva says in Shiva Sutra, Nanam Bandha. Knowledge is the bondage, because knowledge only comes in the form of thoughts, right? So you have a car. Neighbor has got an SUV car. SUV car is better than my car is the knowledge. It'll keep on coming. The knowledge becomes your bondage in the form of thoughts. Okay. And all knowledge is dependent on who am I knowledge. So once you start getting established who am I knowledge, who am I dissolves. The knowledge, whatever is there, becomes information, not bondage. Knowledge is useful. So for you come here, you need address. But you have added masala to that. Psychological content. The psychological content is in the form of I am. The psychological content I am starts dissolving. The knowledge becomes a pure information rather than bondage. You can't wipe out the hard disk in the memory. But instead of that, psychological content gets cleared. I am so and so. Right? I am giving the example of SUV again. So I have a Maruti car and he has a SUV car, my neighbor. So he has a SUV car. I am a poor fellow. Okay? So this is the knowledge. So now here, what causes you thoughts is SUV is very expensive, fine. I am a poor fellow is because I am associating poverty with the car. So when you realize I am Atma, I am neither poor nor rich, nor that fellow is anybody. Right? Then the information remains. SUV car is expensive, this car is poor. This car is cheap. Is information remains. But I am poor goes because I am Atma now. Got it? So the whole problem in suffering in our life is because I am something is the concept. That I am something has to be dissolved through Atmadhyana. Again, Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Okay? The Mukti or liberation only comes through Shravana Matrena. What is the path of Mukti? Shravana Matrena. Atmadhyana has to be explained very, very, because we have a lot of concept. I do this practice, something will give me Mukti or liberation and all. Vedanta is very clear. Knowledge has to be ended with knowledge only. There are so many mechanical practices we do. Finally, ignorance will go because of jnana. The knowledge has to be ended. Veda anta, the end of knowledge can happen only through knowledge. Ignorance about self can happen only, can be removed only through knowledge of self. Is it clear? No. By doing so many years of practice, I will get some jnana? No. Jnana comes by hearing. Practice you are doing to earlier vasanas you are there, no? They are cleaning up. Are you getting what I'm saying? by some practicing samadhi repeatedly, nobody gets enlightened. Samadhi is only helping you to remove the earlier vasanas. I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. It is already recorded in the memory. You have to do little bit right. I am the Atma. But I am the Atma Jnana can only come through Shravana, listening.
Yes.
To the real, from the realized masters. That's why Mukti is only Shravana Matrena. Shravana Matrena. Okay? Why Shravana Matrena? I'll tell you. Okay? For us to get Jnana, five senses are there: eyes, nose, tongue, skin, and hearing. Okay? Jnana can only come through this. But Atma cannot be seen, cannot be touched, cannot be experienced, right? Cannot be seen also. So, and no matter what you do, you will not be able to get an Atma. The Atma is there, you are that Atma, Atma is Brahman, he is not a subject matter of your knowledge. But I am a body, I am the mind, I am the intellect, is a subject matter of your knowledge. Now this wrong knowledge has to be dissolved with the right knowledge. Only right knowledge can dissolve wrong knowledge, nothing else will dissolve. So million times of some practice will not dissolve your wrong knowledge. The right knowledge has to be given to you. The right knowledge can only come through ears. Okay? Right? That is called Shravana Matrena. Listening. Only listening will help you. Samadhi practice only is clearing your earlier impressions. The distinction is clear. Because if you start thinking that by Samadhi I will get in something, no. By Jnana you will get something. Samadhi you are actually implementing it. Okay? So somebody said in Samadhi he had a realization?
No.
No. In Samadhi you start understanding vasanas about yourself. Whatever Jnana is there, I am Atma, will get established in Samadhi. It's only digestion process. Are you clear?
Can Atmadhyana happen without Nididhyasa?
No. We'll come to that. And then Atmadhyana can happen without Nididhyasa. Yes. Atmadhyana can happen without Nididhyasa by listening. Okay. So question is whether Atmadhyana can happen without Nididhyasa. Yes. That's why it's called Shravana Matrena. Jnana. Okay, now that is sufficient for a very very evolved soul, right? Because for coming to Atmadhyana, he has already done lot of sadhana, where he has developed sadhana sampatti, shama, dama, titiksha, oparati, shraddha, samadhana. He has almost come to Atma stage. Now only missing link is you are the Atma, clear clarity has not come. So that's why the highest level of seeker, the moment Guru tells that you are Atma, why and so, so you'll get Atmadhyana. But that's very, very rare, one in million. For most of the people, they are not, the prerequisite is not met. Are you getting what I'm saying? I am the body, vasana is there. So for removing that I am the body, vasana, you have to again and again practice samadhi. But jnana can come only through shravana. Is this much clear? That's why you have to repeat shravana, manana, nididhyasa. For right text. So start doing something, I am this thing, it will not help you. You have to get to core Atmadhyana, Atmadhyana teaching, Shishankara, Ramana Maharshi, Nisargadatta Maharaj, Atmananda Krishna, these type of people. Or listen to the talks of a Jnani. So Jnana alone can destroy ignorance, Shravana Matrena, and Jnana has to come from the right source. Okay? From a realized master, this thing. And it should have right authenticity. Authenticity comes from the Vedanta. Because realized master says, so this is my Jnana, this is what Jnana I have. But this Jnana has come to me from so many rishis who are also having this Jnana. I am only collaborating. No, I found something special, these guys didn't find. Then don't go to such a gurus. I only know something which other people don't know. It's not possible. Neither in Jnana, Atmadhyana, not in the world also. There's no, if you know something X, somebody will know X plus Y. There's always people who are better than you. So that's why somebody's Jnana is in tune with the Rishi's Jnana. Many Rishis. So this will be corroborated by Vedanta Jnana. So this is actually Shravana, Manana, nididhyasa. Right? Okay. This is the practice you have to continue in life. So it is said that ajiva paryantam. Okay, as you are, the ajiva paryantam can be translated in two ways. Ajiva paryantam means
the whole life.
Vedanta shravana manana nididhyasa has to be practiced. Okay, it can be told in other way. Ajiva paryanta means as long as you consider yourself as jiva. The once you are considered as atma, you don't have to do it. Right? So those who don't understand this essence, they'll say, oh, ajiva paryanta. Really, ajiva paryanta means as long as you treat yourself as jiva, shravana manana nididhyasa. Okay? Right? So this is, first I told you lesson number one and lesson number last. Now what are the practices you have to do? I am telling Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. What is Nididhyasa? I will teach you. Samadhi practices. Are you clear? Then second, how you have to handle in life, you have to live in the present moment always. Not in the past, not in the future. This moment you have to learn. How to live in the moment, present moment, I have told you many times. I will give you some practice also today. Live in the present moment, not in the past, not in the future. Come to the present moment again and again. In the present moment, only Atma is there. Are you clear? Then second most important mantra you have to remember. What is that? Tatata. Tatata. Okay, don't get disturbed by anything in life because everything has its own nature. The fire is burning, tatata. The water is cold, tatata. Husband or wife is like that, tatata. Okay, no, they will have to change. Okay, so the change has to come from themselves. You have to, your change is in your control. Somebody else's change, you can do something, but it is, they have to work on that. So when you start accepting the nature of things as they are, you will not get angry or agitated. Ta ta ta. Right? So that is second. Third thing is act. Inaction, no action, a reaction is not okay. Action is required in the present moment. Do best of your ability. Do whatever is required to get the good result. Now whatever result doesn't come, don't bother. Go ahead. Inaction, no. Reaction, no. Okay? Right action, to the best of your knowledge, do it. If results don't come, don't worry. Keep going. So finally, you have to come to a stage, I am not the doer, but there's a doing. Doership goes, doing remains. Thinkership goes, thinking remains. Knowership goes, knowing remains. Okay? That's finally last stages. Where? Then finally, thinker's thinking goes, knowing goes, doing goes, Atma only remains. Right? That is. No, even these are all enlightenment, right? So I'm saying that's what will happen. Okay, basically. So one mantra is Nanu Nanambud Nanala. Second mantra is Tathata. Third is act. Fourth is live in the present moment. Okay? Not in the past, not in the future. Fifth is Shravana Manana Nididhyasa. Sixth is seva, service. Okay? Seva is nothing but pancha yadnas, five yadnas, which I will teach you in the next class when we go to Goshala. So that is the last lesson, but we will conclude the Atmadhana class here. Okay? So service. So life is about Atmano Mokshartham Jagadhitayaja. For my liberation, what I do, I have to continue to work. Nobody is going to save you except yourself. Okay? You are the savior of yourself. And that saving can happen through Atmadnana, Atmadana can happen through Vedanta Dana. Vedanta Dana can happen to through a realized master. No solutions. There's no shortcut, nothing else. Shravana, Manana, Vidhivyasa. Okay? That's for Atmano Mokshartha. Jagadita is how I can do service to the world. Okay, I have come to this level where I am getting highest and highest of truths of Atmadana, which is liberating. There are many beings who are suffering. I cannot help, I cannot do a lot of work. Whatever within my limitation I do it every day. So every day you have to live with the understanding Atmano Mokshartham Jagadidaya. Act, react, no reaction. Present moment, no past, no future. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Okay? This is how you have to live.